messenger of the gods you are if you couldn't beat me here.
My dear, it isn't about speed. It's about
time.
What I would have said
if I had let you. But what's the point in that? T, my lord, Hermes.
Yes, and thank you, Balbo.
For the tea?
No, for the my lord.
You owe me a thanks for the tea. What do you say?
I'd say I was a god who did not need
want this poor, decrepit mortal to make him the best cup of tea he's ever had.
Thank you for the tea, Balbo.
Don't mention it, my lord.
You seem to insist.
That's two of us, lord.
Oh, please stop.
Who are your friends?
No one special. But then most of you aren't. These are just locks. Occasionally, I get someone exceptional. I'm always amazed you can see them and not be dead yourself.
Well, I've been closer to the death end of things for a few years now. Here's your tea. Tell us a tale.
You'll never guess who was on Olympus last night.
That's right, I won't guess because you're going to tell me.
Iacchus drank his father under the table again.
Well, when you're the god of wine and ecstasy, that's not too surprising. For that, I made you tea.
Before Zeus took his final nods last night, he received a message, a prophecy from the oracle at Delphi. You'd better put on water for more tea.
What? That dog of a story?
No, I can hear Iacchus trying to wake Triptolemus with all the stumbling stealth he can manage.
Come on, move!
All subtlety is the god. So, a prophecy delivered to Zeus. Who delivered the message?
Why me?
Of course. And the one delivered to Demeter's temple last evening.
I can't tell you about that one. Because he didn't open it in front of me.
And that stopped you? Well, I can tell you what I know from my end, which is nothing. Metanera has been hiding with her goddess since then, and I've been shut out.
Meanwhile, back on Olympus, Zeus had me read his aloud. He was in no state. Neither was anyone else. They're in the hallway now.
Triptolemus, come in here!
This is not my idea. I'd rather be sleeping until my shift at the temple begins.
Getting too old for a drinking life?
Why? It's impossible to keep up with the god, no matter how young you are. Where is Iacchus?
Hiding in the hallway. He told me to say I was going out on my own.
Here, have a biscuit. Everybody loves my biscuits, especially the goddess. I know how she likes them, even if she doesn't.
Oh, really?
I invoke thee, O Lord of the Vine. You drunken dancer in darkened hallways, enter! Oh, enter, you ass, and have some tea.
Balbo, dear! I answer thy entreaties personally and in person.
Iacchus, my fuzzy-headed god. Sit your sorry behind down. Tea and a biscuit, take it. Triptolemus, have another biscuit. You're going to need it.
Don't forget to say thanks.
That's just you, Hermes. Sorry! Lord Hermes.
Well, Hermes, so good to see you away from Olympus. I didn't see you over there. What a party was had last night, hey?
Yeah.
Hey! What did you get to do with this party besides deliver prophecies?
Well, he helped me pour the wine, of course. Even the cupbearers were too trashed, so Hermes helped save the day and the scent is saying we're flowing.
So, he was serving his fellow gods.
Don't even go there, Balbo.
Go where?
Balbo insists that Lord Hermes is a servant just like her, so why should she call him Lord?
What delivers messages for the gods is at the beck and call of Zeus at any and all hours, provides a service to dead people who need to cross the street, and pours wine.
Patron of multitaskers?
A servant, maybe. Flashier than me, certainly more pretentious, but a servant nonetheless.
Just hope you don't lose your way when you die.
And as a final proof, an overwhelming love of gossip, because
Maiden, ha!
Persephone and her maids would be in the meadow.
As they have morning after morning, millennia after millennia.
I have thought to bring my swiftly aging friend here to a place of rest.
Take me from my place of rest.
So you can rest when you're dead. Hey, Hermes.
Me, here, take these biscuits with and a little cheese in case you have to soak up more wine this morning.
I probably will, thanks. Oh, and if you see my mother before I do, tell her I'll get back to my real work as soon as I can.
Trip, you wound me. Good morning, Balbo. Good day, Lord. go on.
Beside me, I walk alone. life above our heads down here, Hermes.
Over your head, anyway.
That's only the dead. And you and I can enter here, not even Zeus.
Certainly Zeus could enter here. In a sarcophagus. Thank you. But I would rather speak of other places. Fragrant flowers. Warmer climes. Come with me. The warmth of the sun in your bones and a little fresh air will do you good. Stretch yourself. Remember when you were young? You are young, and the story is young. Remember when your world was larger and reach for it again.
Reach once more for what? The world? A chance to roll the bones again and lose to loaded dice.
Never prove it.
And never charged by Poseidon or myself, who provided the dice herbs.
Before my time and in another place. But none of you brothers were firstborn, so none of you get to cry thief. Yes, my lord. In addition to my cheery company, the usual compliment of the dead, and my invitation to take a walk with me, I have a message for you.
Oh, really? A message? What is it?
Rejoice!
I like that, it's gooder.
Rejoice. Is that all?
No!
Hermes, are you more insufferable than usual today?
Yes. Well, I've been learning from an expert this morning, and I thought I should practice. Well, anyway, Zeus commands you.
Myself can see. Oh, if only it was so.
It can be so, it will be so, it must be so, so mote it be.
Well, who is it I'm supposed to marry? Prophecy or no, I will not marry anyone I couldn't love.
I've been forbidden to talk to you about that.
Oh, convenient that.
Sorry. Come with me, as fresh and dewy as the day you were born. Let me lead you out by unknown paths, and we will breathe in the upper air together.
So mote it be.
Before the dawn, the earth is rich and slow. I walk the fields as the day is breaking. I sing my song in the early glow.
Did she really just say glance?
Uh-huh.
to your roots and bring it back again. Dread Lord, have I the honor of addressing?
My lady, I am Hades.
My lord, if I am your lady, I ask you to let go of me.
Why?
Why? Because I ask you to.
Haven't I heard this story before? Do you come to seize me? Do you come to pull me below? If so, you should know that I have gone strong.
Your idea of seduction?
Only a new story.
To you the
be married against my will.
And how does that sit with my lord?
Not well. I care not for forced things.
You care not for things forced from themselves. What of the usurped underworld you rule?
Yes, you are correct.
Yeah.
It was stolen from the goddesses, and I am the one who helped steal it. But I love the deeps, and I care for the dead as far as I'm allowed, if that makes a difference.
Tell me more about your stolen home.
It is the black of a painted knight. Stars on a velvet spangled cloak. Long, rushing rivers of curling silver tumbling over buried chasms. A galaxy of mist descending.
Ha my lord! To Olympus we must go, where there are stars to be seen
is
as well.
Is there a rush, Hermes?
Is there a rush, goddess?
I need to be alone again, before my day begins, which is now already has been.
Huh?
What? My lady, we will see each other again.
Yes, we will.
How about your leave?
Your leave to what?
To leave, my lady?
Oh, you have my blessing.
What about me?
So nice. Goodbye.
She wants to be alone, she said.
She wants to get back to work, she said.
I want to know what just happened between you and Lord Hades.
Did something just happen?
No evasion, lady. It was as if time stopped and the moment became about the two of you like magic or something.
Music began to swell.
The very moment throbbed. You two just stood there.
Very suspicious.
And yet, moment by moment, the morning grows and once again we go back to the fields.
Beautiful country below. They go down, they go down. lovely man. He's so constant and strong. He's the priest I love best, and he knows our work intimately. I don't believe he'll disappoint. I've had my eye on him for some time.
But if I don't want to marry him, Mother, you marry him.
Want doesn't enter into this. The fates through the Oracle at Delphi have decreed thusly, and it is not our place to deny fate. We announce the wedding tomorrow.
Delphi? A prophecy? How long have you known of this?
Since early yesterday evening when Hermes the Stork delivered this burden. Metnair and I have been tearing the words apart to determine their meaning.
These words would sentence me for no crime committed. This should be my choice. What if I were in love with someone else?
Hey! This is not about choice. This is about your destiny. This is about your role as my daughter. Do you love someone else?
My role as your daughter? You chose to have two children and to raise them without their father. You chose not to marry. Why shouldn't I have that same choice?
Because you're the daughter that I love above all else, and I won't see you hurt in the ways that I was. My choices, as you call them, were hard and painful. This prophecy is timely. You should be grateful your path is laid out so clearly.
I should be indeed, Mother, and beg you to reconsider the meaning of whatever these words are in the light of my choice.
Beg you as well, daughter mine.
I must return to work for now, Mother. See? Phoebus Apollo shows the hour so late, with duties still to fulfill and never before fail.
So formal.
Zoe, Chloe, Metanoe, say good morning and farewell to my mother.
Great lady, bless us with thy increase.
Be wary, Zoe. Ariakis may bless you with increase.
Yes, lady.
Great goddess, may we reap all the joy we deserve.
You are young.
No blessings for you, Metanoe.
I'm fine, goddess.
Well then, I'll say good morning to you, Eucore. Sweet maidens of the meadow.
Rejoice!
Rejoice! Ah!
Chloe, is there something wrong with rejoicing?
I refuse to answer on grounds of fear.
Persephone.
Chloe. You threw her on Olympus last night, right? How is Iacchus?
Oh, he's fine, m'lady.
Subject change. Awkward. How fine is he?
As fine as silk sheets.
Smooth and slippery.
Oh, I did not need to know that. Are you sure? I'm sure that you are still a quarry.
Yes.
Your brother is frustrated, is what he is, Lady Persephone.
Now that I enjoy hearing.
But what about you?
What about me?
What about Lord Hades?
Rejoice, Mabry.
Let it out, lady.
A beautiful morning made more perfect by happy chance, happy, happy chance, to find a quarry at work in this meadow. Good morning, lovely sister.
Rejoice.
Why?
You're the god of ecstasy, and you're asking me why.
Yes.
Well then, rejoice, Triptolemus of the house of Ventnera, my husband-to-be. I await thy every husbandly command.
Wait a minute, you aren't joking.
Apparently it's a prophecy.
A mother and Hades?
Somehow I don't think it's the same prophecy.
Hades and my mother? That will never happen.
Not if I can help it. I mean, I don't think that
good morning! So we.
Marry Hades.
Morning, my lord, Yap.
Of course, it's four positions.
Tangerine!
Yap is bring her back!
Blood
and
pain.
Never
talk outside of.
So, you lucky couple, you have the two of you meet!
Oh, see, my mother proclaims this to me with no objection by me to be had.
I haven't seen my mother or yours this morning. I need to speak to her. It's not that I don't find you attractive, goddess.
Principle of the thing, and that's all. I'm sure. Nothing else.
Persephone.
Nothing.
Iacchus, I'm leaving.
What? No!
I'll not.
Nor I.
Thank you.
Then let's go. Ladies, you so remind me of. Never mind you. Just remind me, I shall return to kiss you in the field.
And would you plow a furrow too? I think not. Back to your vines and arbors, brother mine.
I trip behind this man, caught up with haste. Oh, lucky sister.
Rejoice.
Persephone.
Yes, Chloe. What of Lord Hades?
else?
I'm not.
Not, huh? I'll tell you what you are. You're in love with someone else, and I don't know who it is. I find that infuriating! Is it Chloe? Zoe?
No.
None of them, Iacus.
But there is someone else.
I did not say that.
Oh, you did not say it either.
Did not say what?
That he's in love? Go ahead, say it.
I will not say that I'm in love.
Are you in love?
Fine, if you won't say it, then I will.
Balbo, dear, I am in love with you.
And I love you as well, my ever-young god, though my body is old enough to be your grandmother.
Now, Balbo, I am a god of vision, and I see you now as when I saw you when you were young.
Trip, I've known you since you were a baby. You've been my best friend for many years. I say you are in love.
I'm getting older.
And I'm not. A curse, my deity loses me those I love. Don't you trust me anymore? If not as a friend, then as a god? Have I ever gotten you into any trouble I couldn't get you out of?
It's not that I don't love or trust you, it's just I know where my future lies, and it's here at the temple, though not married to Persephone.
I know what goddess receives your fervent worship. A more attentive priest my mother will never have. I admit to some jealousy. I admit that I might.
You're not in love with my mother, are you?
What?
Would anyone else like a drink? I know I would. Why, thank you, I will.
Yes?
How long have you been
here? His whole life.
Every time he said it, I remember now. Every time he said it, from when he was a baby to just now, he's meant it in that way.
Do you know of the next they draw around Persephone and yourself?
Yes, we've just come from the Meadow of Delight, Persephone told me. Are my mother and the goddess in the temple?
Waiting to receive petitioners, waiting for you! Your mother did try to find you this morning, and you must have just missed Demeter at the meadow.
Of course.
What's your intent?
To talk them out of this!
No. I counsel you, do not yet make my mother aware of your love. Be charming, be indirect. Be poetic. She's a sucker for poetry, Dad says.
Oh, yeah. Goddess.
Sorry, he doesn't belong in this conversation.
Poetry?
If she inspires you, then be inspired. A great love indeed to aspire to a goddess. So, let's celebrate this great love. Hail, holy love, finest wine, grown in clusters on the vine, ever flowing through our bodies and our times. We are the leaves, the glowing grapes, we are the mystery of wine, a holy alchemy, a taste of the divine.
Kettle or the fire? Only one way to know.
occupies his time this morning. There's no one waiting at the moment, and I'm troubled, Metnera, but, well, not about that. Persephone, she's never balked me before. Joining of our children is not something they have to love, but what else could the oracle mean but this? Mistress, must it be this generation? Persephone is a goddess. She will remain young far longer than a mortal. Perhaps the oracle meant a grandchild of mine and not my son. The words are for the times they're spoken in. You oppose this union as well? You'll become a god because of it.
Well, deity has its price. I would remain mortal, given the choice. I'm as human as any of your prior priestesses. In my lifetime, I have known desire, pleasure, birth, loss. I have grown and flourished, and now I decay and decline.
There is a blush still on your cheek, Mamera.
Dust, a rot to meld upon petals at fullness. But I would have it no other way. Tell me, how many more lifetimes have you been this mother, this embodiment of harvest?
More than I care to recall.
Recall then? A coray. A springing, dancing force of joy recently released from captivity, relishing in her new world.
And what happened to her?
Well, the rolling storm in the fullness of the fields and meadows conceived, and from their union came two beautiful children. The light that touches the beginning of life and the light of holy ecstasy.
And by these chains of love, she was forever bound into her role of mother.
You chose to make love to Zeus.
Passion can destroy all choice.
No, we arrive again at these words. The houses of Demeter and Metanera will twine together, sprouting new vines.
What of love?
What of it?
Yes, I've longed for love and for happiness, but this green mantle drags at my shoulders and crones me before my time.
There is no reason not to lay it aside every once in a while. You know, Balbo would say.
Oh, don't tell me what Balbo would say. I'm sure it would shock us both.
No. Gone are the days when I would let my pleasure overtake my duty. Zeus the Thunderer was very good at some things, but love he's incapable of. And now he's married. You see, duty is a constant. Tertullus must be outside. Let's show the next petition.
Welcome to the indwelling presence of the goddess!
I seek a private audience with the goddess as a supplicant and not as her priest.
I must speak with you for a moment.
Don't worry, Mother. I already got the message you sought to give me. I just wish to speak to the goddess and then return to my duties.
The goddess here is in grand thy audience. Metnera, you can step outside.
Yes, goddess.
So, what would the man I would consider my son ask of me?
I do not ask for that honor. I wouldn't disrespect the wishes of my goddess, and yet...
Tertullus, I've never seen disrespect out of you toward myself or any living thing.
Well, Babel might take exception.
So she should. No, I've noticed your quiet and rather burning devotion. You've earned the right to speak your mind.
Well, this is my heart that speaks. I cannot marry Persephone. I beg you to reconsider your will.
How many times do I have to say this is not my will?
I love another!
Love another. And who is this that can outmatch my Persephone? You've been so far bold. Continue.
My avatar of love raises a calm storm. The spray of her perspiration, trickling rivulets that crisscross in a classic design. A great treasure, an entire hoard contained in one precious gem. The velvet sounds of night enfold her steely strength, enclosed in petals, no mere goddess, but a woman. The stars pause, waiting for a single falling word to burn to dust in the upper air. They are blind, and without eyes to see, and so stare when only a glance will suffice. Her dance never ends, and cutting their figures, would-be lovers clamor and compete for just one kiss from her. Aphrodite pales in comparison.
Some woman will find herself much the poorer for loss of this worship. I find myself strangely jealous. What name graces one so lucky and unlucky?
I may not say.
What? Do you love some married woman?
Married not to a man, but to her position.
Some priestess, then.
If I'm to write Persephone, what does it matter?
Triptolemus, whether my daughter has your love or not, she's well blessed in this union. I couldn't ask more for her, nor for myself. Pity you this love, but I cannot swear fate. You will marry Corey.
For the love I bear my goddess, I'm sorry for all this.
As am I. Return to your duties with my blessing. And Sir Thomas, I do wish things could be otherwise.
Obscured her face, I heard a question in the darkness. Why are you trying to make my granddaughter marry someone she doesn't love?
Now, if you were as magical and mystical as you have us all think, you wouldn't need to ask.
Oh, I know. Delphi dropped a steaming load in your lap. As an oracle of no mean skills myself, I know how open and empty such words can be. For example, Metanera. Your husband has been among the dead for years now. You could marry Iacchus.
What?
Or Iacchus could marry Triptolemus. Or you could marry Triptolemus.
No matter, you go too far.
Although in your case, I'm not sure why anyone would be attracted to you, Zeus aside. Well, you are young, as goddesses go, so I suppose that's something. Oh, by the way, Metanera, It's quite a lad you raised there. Nice calves.
Mother, please stop wasting my time.
I have never wasted your time. But you always say it when you choose not to listen to me. I will leave now. I'll take the time to annoy you again sometime soon, fear not. Final word, there are other prophecies afoot. Metanera, daughter, gentlemen.
Peace again. But I have to tell Zeus about the wedding.
Goddess, your mother spoke of another prophecy.
And
it involves you.
A toast to the storm as the clouds begin to thunder. We raise our glasses high to the sky we revel under. Lightning lights up the night as we celebrate the wonder of the storm. May it never pass us by. Bouldering this evening, I'd like to see you later, but sooner would be greater. This evening, my dear, I adore you so, and I swear that I will never let you go. Well, hello, my dear, you are the rose this evening. I'd like to see you later and make your glow grow greater. This evening, my dear, if the heavens with your light.
Hades, my brother, have a drink. Don't be so sober.
Effervescence could become you.
As you will. Couldn't you at least pretend to enjoy yourself? If ever the bow of your lips were drawn, you would fire unerring arrows. A family trait, eh, Iacus? Brother, observe the targets arrayed for your gaze.
Ah, has mighty Zeus turned Olympus into a brothel for my benefit? Thank you, but no.
Don't be rude, Hades. I summoned you here with your interest paramount, yet you deliberately misunderstand me.
I do not misunderstand that you summoned me here. What gives you the right to order me about?
I am the Lord of Olympus!
Won by the roll of the dice.
What is life?
Demeter. At least that's what we think. All the rest of
threatened, brother.
Oh, brother. All of this quarreling is wrong and absurd. This is a party, or hadn't you heard? Look, the sky is shining, the company divine. Join the dancing, taste the wine. Let's drink to family. This one's for family. One more round.
One more round.
You forget to eat down there, Hades. Eat all you wish.
I grew used to the lack of food, buckle, and combined in Cronus's belly, but you would know nothing of that.
I would think a little gratitude for your freedom would be in order.
Oh, gratitude to your server.
No hypocrisy, Lord Hades. Remember the lady.
Yes, you are correct. We are thieves together, am I right, Zeus?
That's more like it.
Her voice is sublime, commanding and peerless ahead of her time, mysterious and questioning and wise.
No, not that stuff. Tell us of her beauty.
Yeah, you saw her, didn't you?
No, no, tell us.
I looked in her eyes and I was filled with desire, like nothing I've ever known. My sovereign promoter was totally overthrown. I'm hungry and burning and filled with a desperate yearning. My love, I see my love, and can it be that she loves me?
Who is this gem? I'd like to meet her.
Persephone.
My daughter?
My sister.
My.
Brother, doesn't this satisfy this prophecy of yours? Will you present my suit to Demeter for the hand of Persephone?
And you call me insane? No, I will not present your suit unless it is to Demeter herself.
You would deny me this.
Not I, Demeter.
Do you really think that she would give her daughter to a brother of mine? I never thought I'd say this, but you've had too much to drink. I mean, think about what you're saying, man. That's just crazy.
It's crazy, Mary Demeter.
Yes. But where does that leave us?
More wine?
More wine!
Our toast to the storm, as the clouds begin to thunder, we raise our glasses high. To the sky we revelunder, lightning lights up the night, as we celebrate the wonder of the storm. May it never pass us by.
A toast to the thunderous storm, the wondrous storm,
the ever-swirling, ever-wondering, ever-rising.
Thank you.
streaming?
Kind of hope not. Hello.
Camera is live. Hi, everybody out there in TV land. Thank you. Thank you.
actually streaming right now, so.
Well, that's great. Yeah.
impact of her voice.
Arise from this muck and mire and show me your face!
Scattered through my scalp.
Stir from this wreckage!
Urge me no more to awaken, woman!
Oh, there you are. Adrift on Olympus' broken shore.
Oh, my appetites died too finely on me. All my sins regurgitate.
Drunken cur. Heal and listen to my words.
Call me dog or call me wolf. Call me king or cur, but please, oh please, oh pretty please, please do it quietly.
Here, bite back at what bit you. Iacchus sends his compliments and commiserations. We have things to discuss. First, you're late with the reins. Do something about it.
Done.
Second, I come to inform you of your daughter's betrothal and impending marriage. I don't require your blessing.
Well, then my blessing's on you for bounties received in days long past.
Your tail still wags your tongue, I see. I was young then and naive. I mistook you for a wolf. Where's Hera?
My loving wife and I are undergoing a trial of great distance rather than of close proximity. If I may ask, who are you marrying my daughter to?
Triptolemus, son of my priestess Metneras, to marry Kore.
Kore, eh? What about Persephone?
This is decreed by prophecy.
Ah, yes, prophecy. Marriage has been on my mind as of late, as well as prophecy.
So I've heard.
Have you? Demeter, marry me and become Queen of Olympus.
What?
Didn't expect that, did you?
And what of Hera?
Divorces as well as marriages are made in heaven. Besides, she doesn't love me, and never did. There was no spark between us, no lightning. Do you remember how it made the clouds bellow and thunder? Do you recall the passion I still see roiling beneath your skin? Even now, that magnetism draws us closer. I remember the grain in your hair, the rustling of your ample...
Zeus! No! You may think you love me. I know I don't love you. Once, perhaps, but now.
Well, then what if my brother hates? Surely you wouldn't pass up the opportunity to regain the womb of night.
Now comes this prophecy of yours.
No more or less valid than the one you received, or do you believe that only your interpretation counts?
Oh, I believe my interpretation issues from an unfevered consideration.
Oh, Persephone agrees with you then.
Make it rain. I have a marriage to announce.
There was once passion, if not love, between us. Please, give the beauty we produced a chance at her own passion.
Mother, I need to speak with you.
The goddess approaches. There is no time.
I think you'd best listen, mistress.
And I think it best you keep your mouth shut around Demeter.
Even if you ordered me, you know I wouldn't.
Couldn't you mean?
Mother, I am in love, but not with Persephone. The goddess already knows this.
This changes nothing.
It changes everything.
The oracle has been consulted.
Have you considered your son's happiness?
Balbo, it occurs to me that a lamp in my chambers was not extinguished upon our departure. Please return and make sure it is out. I would have a house to return to.
Mistress!
I would rather you keep your tongue there than lose it here. Go.
Mother, do you love Demeter?
Trip, of course I do.
Are you afraid of her?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Trip?
Come, let us stand together for the first and last time.
Let the world know what begins here. From mother to mother, we cast the nets between us.
From mother to mother, we pull our nets to shore.
Tighter and closer, we tie the sheaves of the harvest.
Sharing vines and roots, our two families will become one.
Persephone, Triptolemus, tomorrow will be your wedding day. Rejoice.
rejoice at the yoke you will pull together to plow the fields of our harvest. Rejoice at your new roles as my right and left hand.
No!
What? Trip, this is a needful duty to your mother's house.
My duty is to myself! Great goddess, Demeter of the harvest, I can no longer be your faithful priest. I break with thee.
Is decreed by prophecy.
No, mother, you have decreed this. If it never happens, then it can't be fate.
Oh, the wisdom of youth. The lessons of the seasons and cycles seem to have left little mark on the two of you. The moon cannot be forced in her path. So much for prophecy.
Prophecy, be damned. I won't see Persephone make my mistake.
Goddess, maybe we should think about it.
Now my priestess turns against me. Regret this, Mitner.
You will not threaten my mother.
What a wonderful son-in-law you would have made.
What are you doing here?
I've come to stand with my daughter for the first time.
Demeter, please listen. I thought I raised you to live with freedom.
You never gave me the gift of structure.
This is no gift. This is a shackle, and I refuse to wear it.
You will not bend. I will break you. I will thresh your grains and grind you into flour for the bread I bake. There'll be a wedding here tomorrow, whether you will it or not.
Daughter, what have you done?
This is ill done.
Shut up, both of you. The time for you to have any say in anything I've done is now come and gone. Cross me if you dare. 70, Tertullus, tomorrow morning.
Persephone, I will not be here tomorrow.
Tertullus!
I could talk sense to her, but I fear.
Always Persephone. You are my daughter as well as Demeter's, and you always have choices. I could shelter you on Olympus, but even there your mother would bring grief. Persephone, there may be a place where you can go, where perhaps your mother cannot. If you can enter it all, there is one there that loves you.
One who loves me?
Yes, if you love him. He wants to marry you. Perhaps I shouldn't have said that. Don't break his heart. If you love him, I mean.
Yes, father.
Daughter, I cannot know what you will do, but I always choose love.
Dark river, no one may follow.
What do you know about it? Is she here on Olympus?
She is not.
Then you know where she is.
I will swear on anything you care to that I do not know where she is.
This smells like the stench of the sons of Cronus. There's a gateway to the underworld at the end of the meadow. Has Hades taken her? Hermes?
Yes, my lady.
Who knows who's everywhere? Did you see Hades take Persephone?
Of all the things my nose has seen, that is not one of them.
Mother, I don't think anybody could take Persephone if she didn't want them to.
You don't know where she is, then be quiet. Put up with too much from you, I always have. You're so much more like your father than your sister is. I forgave you your charming failings, but no more.
Do you value me so little? Am I only a constant reminder of my father's foibles, born to be your clown and Persephone your sacrifice? To what?
Turn your face from my sight.
You too!
My goddess?
My lady?
I compel you to tell me the truth of what you've seen.
My lady, we reported for our duties this morning and all was as you saw. Lady Persephone never appeared.
And you?
You slapped her yesterday.
What?
Compelled.
What compelled you to slap Persephone?
I was performing my duty as a mother.
A duty to slap your child.
Why don't we just sober up for a moment and calm down?
Give her back to me.
We don't have her!
I see how it is. You all conspire.
Give you
wrong for the time being.
Oh, I thought you might.
Could have been wrong. You weren't. Tell me what else brings you here.
Part of me.
Physical treasures, then I would have more than I could discover in eternity. I don't think Zeus knows how much beauty lies in the roots of the world.
Wouldn't you rather rule on Olympus?
Far too noisy up there having to host all those parties. I like the silences here.
Silences? It's not always silent?
At times, I wander deeper. Even the dead behind, there are absolute voids of space where any sound is reduced to less than nothing. And then there's the sound of the earth grinding his teeth like an old woman filled with secrets. The music is spring, rills, waterfalls. Then I go up to the upper caverns and the dead swarm me until I welcome them. I remember the first time they came at me. I didn't know what they wanted. I felt the need in their song and I was compelled to open up my arms to them. And that's how it's been.
What do they do?
What do they do? Well, they just sit there and pupate. They love to talk. They talk about the poor and powerful alike.
Pupate? Like butterflies?
I suppose. Though I've never seen one molt in all the time I've been down here. It feels as if the story hasn't changed in a long time. Longer than many of the other times.
long winter snow.
Is that something I could do? Can there be a blue gloomy? In the darkness below. What if my answer is no?
No. I don't understand. Crossing to a land you've seen in dreams. Wouldn't you like to stay here? Isn't that why you came here?
This place is heaven, but the world above is home. I don't mean to confuse you. I don't know how to choose.
Find my daughter, and no one will interfere, not even my mother. This disguise will keep the gods at bay, and no mortals will fear to talk to me. I'll start right here in Eleusis. Where is that well?
I wouldn't have believed it if you had told me.
But we were there.
Poor Persephone. I know.
Oh, pardon me. May I intrude?
Oh, you don't have a cup. Do you need a drink?
Oh. Thank you, young lady. And your name is?
Zoe. This is Chloe and Madanoe.
Oh, well, I am Agatha.
But how could she do that? Well, Yakis says she's achieved the mental state of a night-flying mammal with defecation issues.
You mean she's gone batshit crazy. And he should know it's a family trait.
Is it his resemblance to Zeus, you mean?
Not really.
What did Iaka say about Persephone?
He wasn't talking about her.
I don't understand.
He was talking about Demeter. Haven't you heard?
Apparently not.
Demeter slapped my mistress Persephone.
Surely a mother has the right to discipline her child.
Persephone is not a child. It was completely uncalled for. Demeter caused this huge scene on Olympus, and then she abandoned.
She's searching for Persephone.
No, do not make excuses for her. She took her powers from the world and she left.
Chloe, she'll be back.
But how long will it take? What if she doesn't find Persephone soon? She might not have to eat, but we do. We, and it's not just humanity, it's everything alive. The world will starve. I'm afraid.
She'll be back, Chloe. I know it.
Let's just hope she knows it.
Well, she... have to go.
What do you think of my mother?
Well, usually I don't have to. But, your mother and grandmother both came down here several days ago looking for you, I think.
Several days? I just left the meadow this morning.
Maybe you did, maybe you didn't. Sometimes time is different as you descend.
Well, what will you do if she returns now, intending to take me back to her temple and marriage?
I'll tell her you're mine now and she can't have you back.
So now I'm yours to keep? What if I don't want to stay here?
I'm confused. What do you want from me?
Are you ever going to ask me to marry you? Zeus told me you talked about it yesterday, or several days ago, whenever.
Now you want me to ask you to marry me.
Maybe.
And here we are.
What would you do if I walked away right now?
I miss you.
Then let me leave so you can begin to miss me. Bye.
No!
No what?
Please don't go. Not yet, please stay.
Why? Why should I stay in a place that for all its beauty?
Because I love you. I know this isn't enough to keep you here. You need your flowers and these to give, but they're the oldest of the dead.
They're beautiful.
Kiss the bride.
No!
Excuse me!
No!
What?
Let's have a big ceremonial thing. did she leave us?
Where's Demeter?
Where is she? Where is she? Where is she? Where is she? No harvest, no yield, no brooms in the fields, no grain in the ground. Nothing will grow. Nothing will grow.
Feed us!
Open the granaries, or else.
Or else what? Whoever said that, come on and step right up, big man. Let's see your ugly face. This woman is doing all she can despite her goddess and despite your complaining. So bugger right off and take a long trip up a short cliff.
We have to be careful with what we have left until the goddess returns.
If she returns, let us in.
Yeah.
Where is she?
We will open the granaries, but it will be rationed. Grind and use your flowers if your life depended on it. This audience has ended.
Dead transform.
Come on, how long were we at it?
Well, I don't know. So many deaths, so many little deaths to account for.
Miss the meadow. And my mother.
I know you have to go. Just come back.
All you get from me is a vacation. I'll be back for you and the dead.
He's dead. I said something's wrong.
Why? We helped them all transform. We finished.
No, move on. Let us stop coming down here. Nor are they departing now that we've changed them. Let us go to the meadow and see what's happening in the world above.
I can't.
What do you mean?
No step will take me out of here. It's my mother. She's done something.
Okay, well, since it seems like you can't, I'll go.
Come back.
I insist you drink with me one last time.
Last drink or not, you always insist.
I don't want you to grow any older, brother.
Well, I'm mortal. I'll always be your friend until the day I die. And then someone else will grow into the boy god's sidekick.
And out again.
Yeah.
Who will help me chase the girls?
Well, you've never needed my help with the boys or girls.
And what about my mother?
Let's not talk about her right now.
We need to talk about her. I'm god enough to know that. So, as a brother, drink with me one last time.
You rely too much on the wine.
Well, help me finish it and I won't be able to rely on it anymore.
As a brother.
One cup for us to share, two sips, two toasts.
Well then, you first.
And last, and always, to Demeter. My mother, your whatever, goddess of the harvest, she cuts things down for people to eat, grains, cereals, to my mother, the cereal killer.
The fields are bare, the cupboards are empty, does she care? Where is she? Where is she? Endlessly fighting some counterfeit war. And I'm still waiting, waving from the shore.
particular ills. You are lost, you will be found. If you seek, you will be sought.
Are you insane, or do you think I'm an idiot?
Did I ask for payment for my miracle potion? I did not. Although, there is always a cause for true knowledge.
Of course there is.
Here, drink this.
Why won't he talk to me?
Excuse me, mistress, he talks to you all the time.
The temple he talks to me.
There will be a time and place.
Can you tell me a story?
There are three sisters, three fates, who spin, measure, and cut. They choose the cloth, the pattern of life to hang at your shoulders, pull in at your hips. They alter and tailor, adjust and let out, until the day you die. Only then can it fit you exactly. Then you take it off and start a new wardrobe.
Was there a point or perhaps some comfort in that?
No, not really. Go to sleep.
It wasn't really a story either.
I've never said I'm perfect. Well, I suppose I have before you comment. Go to sleep.
Dream until the dawn. Let your heart be still. Though the night is long, I will still be here, and I will hold you. I will hold you near.
Oh, some pretty impressive tea. Bitter.
Well, I'd offer you some milk and sugar, but since we're in the grip of a deadly famine, I suppose not. Oh, haven't you heard? Demeter absconded with the temple gold and an altar boy 3 months ago, leaving everyone to starve and, of course, die.
That can't be. I haven't been gone that long.
Well, she's been gone 3 months. I don't know about you. Wait. Did you just say that's how long you've been gone? 3 months? Just like her.
Yeah, just like her.
And where have you been, sister?
I'm looking for my daughter, if you must know.
Just like her!
Really?
And why are you looking for your daughter?
I think she was stolen from me.
Stolen? What, was she in a jewelry box? Oh, you mean kidnapped. Abducted?
Yes.
Because stolen. Not like she was a possession or something. You got a name?
Yes.
Me too. And your daughter, she got a name?
Corey.
Corey? Young maid? That's your daughter's name? Well, that should create any difficulties in your search. I'm looking for my daughter. Oh, well, what's your name? Young maiden. Oh, well, wait just a minute. I'm sure one will be by soon.
Trip, I have something very important to say. Very important. I need to lie down. That last bit of wine seems to have finished me off. I don't know what...
When I am gone, you'll find another to serve in my stead.
child spoken in the house of your desire. Does that mean anything to you?
Maybe.
House of your desire, huh? Hot to trap with someone?
No.
Hold on, let me try again. Faithful servant, bursting with love and humility? Perhaps.
Well, back there. At the temple.
Well, there. Where do you think you're going? You haven't got your money's worth yet.
I haven't paid you anything. I'm still looking for my daughter.
You have no idea what you're looking for. Sit. You will sit. Or stand. Find a nice comfortable position. Now breathe, girl. Align your spine. Did you say?
Yes.
You're not helping.
Warm, buttery biscuits.
Dream until the dawn.
Mother, gone. She was at her pier. Why do I still smell biscuits? Balbo. Balbo will have biscuits.
Not my husband, I assure you. is it? The goddess hasn't been gone that long.
3 months! With nothing new growing and all the old being eaten. No one had enough food put aside, not even us. Even though that's what this temple is here for, to feed people.
This is a temple to Demeter.
Who should be about feeding the people. Anyway, what brings you here?
I'm searching for something precious, something stolen from me.
An earring? Your virginity? You'll never find that again, no matter how long you search. Let me tell you, I've tried!
My daughter disappeared. I believe she was taken, and I'm trying to find her.
Well, I've been trying to find her, too!
Her daughter?
Yes, her daughter.
My daughter?
Yes, my daughter.
Weary travelers, receive freely the bounty of this temple, home to the goddess Demeter. I'm sorry, there's so little to offer.
Truly all you can offer me? What about your biscuits?
Biscuits?
Well, I'm going to save mine for my daughter.
There's not enough flour left, but wait! I have a small handful of grapes I've squirreled away. From very special grapes, don't you know?
Hey, those are mine!
What was that?
Just guess. You know raisins. I can't eat them if I had to. Here you go, mistress.
Thank you.
Ma'am.
I get gas too.
Well, keep it to yourself. Well, I guess this is sort of a last supper, as the raisins are all we have left beyond a week's worth of flour.
These raisins are amazing.
So how long have you been looking for your daughter?
Amazing. 3 months.
Really? Just like the goddess. I guess there's something going around. What are you running away from?
What do you mean?
I mean, I think Demeter has run away from her responsibilities and is using looking for her daughter as an excuse while people suffer.
I'm sure she didn't mean to hurt us by what she
did. Yes,
she
did, Mother. She took her guilt on having driven Persephone off out on the entire world.
Yeah, but she wasn't thinking.
You got that right.
Talk about her that way. You, a priest.
She was being selfish. I never would have thought her of it.
Her daughter had been stolen.
Oh! She slapped her daughter and tried to force her to marry me.
Oh, no, she didn't. Her prerogative. As a mother.
Not the goddess I want to worship and love.
Well, the goddess I worship. The goddess I worship.
As a goddess.
Are those raisins bad, Beverly? Because I'm feeling funny. It's funny. I have to say this, but Demeter had no right to do what she did do.
She had every right. She had a mother's right.
What does that mean? A mother's right? I'm a mother. You're a mother. Boo Boo's a mother. You gotta go sometimes.
I lose them all anyway. To spouses, lovers, their children, their grandchildren. I've lost children as well. I sometimes have phantom labor pains as if their ghosts are trying to be reborn.
What? That is totally a new one. Have you heard this trend?
Full of surprises, Sir Babbly.
Oh, no, not now. Oh, it's happening again. I can feel the contractions. Give me your hand, please.
Oh, maybe it's just gas.
It's my baby trying to come through. Oh, my goddess, it's crowning. My goodness, that's a big one. He's got to be in the top percentile. Wait a minute. That's not one of my babies. It's one of yours, isn't it?
Mother, it's okay. You're home now.
Demeter!
Goddess, restore the green. Restore your blessing.
Where's my daughter?
Oh. Your daughter.
I have been looking for you for the past
one last favor to ask.
Now that she had gone down there.
You know I've come to get her.
I really don't think...
I know. Let me in! Give me my daughter! Why can't I enter?
She's not mine to give,
Mother.
I give you my permission to enter. But it's not just mine you need. You see, you also need my queen's, which you would like to give, but cannot.
Your queen? My Cora?
Our Persephone.
My wife.
You mean... Can't be. She was supposed to marry Triptolemus, the
That
fate.
Doesn't matter! We love each other. That is fate.
What do you mean? She can't give me permission.
Your curse must be lifted.
I didn't curse
it! Remove your blessing. Don't be simple. You interrupted the great cycle. Life removed, but not death removed. Just look at all the debt around you.
Excuse me, coming through? Special delivery, express service.
Sir!
Will you sign for this, please?
You're not taking incoming at the moment. I'm sorry.
Well, in that case, here is a personal message for Demeter.
No, not her. Not Valbo.
She was weak from having starved herself, making sure my mother had enough. She was doing for me. Who are you, my goddess?
No more excuses. Let the green grow again and heal the cracked heart of the earth, our mother.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Persephone, Queen of the Endless Night!
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for so many things. I never should have slapped you. I never should have tried to make you married. I never. Now everything's gone so wrong. How many more of the dead are on my hands? I only wanted to make sure you were happy.
What about your happiness, Mother?
You and Iacchus are my only happiness.
Why?
Because the temple, my duties, raising children.
Your temple and your children stand tall. Your duties are well tended by those who love you.
Because?
Yes, Persephone.
Because when you have children, you too will see how much of your life becomes.
But your daughter is right, my lady. If you don't allow a place in your heart for love, how can it be filled?
After all the wrong I've done, I don't deserve happiness.
Deserve happiness? You're not the only one here who's committed crimes of some sort. Do I deserve happiness? I may not feel like I do, but happiness doesn't care if I deserve it or not. It is here to claim me like an arrow to the heart. Who am I to turn away from it? I believe my brother would say, choose happiness, choose love.
I try.
Can you ever forgive me, Persephone?
I was so angry with you. You frustrated me before, but never made me so, so angry. I never disobeyed you or talked back to you much, and to be treated like a child. I always did what you said because it made sense, until it didn't. I suppose I could have told you I'd fallen in love.
That would have made it worse.
Mother, you see that my choices were well made?
Yes.
I forgive you, Mother.
I never should have believed that prophecy.
A prophecy, so
which are being fulfilled by Hades and Persephone, and you, and Triptolemus!
Return to the house of your desire!
my brother is going
to yeah, die.
Every morning. Strike me dead for presumption if you must, but I love you. My avatar of love.
Raises a calm storm. Spray of perspiration, trickling rivulets, crisscrossing in a classic design.
In my dreams, I swim through deep pools.
Of perspiration?
Of grain. Deep pools, abundant oceans of grain. Each a star falling through your hair. An infinity.
To what end these falling stars, so seemingly eternal? To what end when all ends?
All ends, linked and forever bound by beginnings through chains of bodies and beating hearts. My avatar of love raises calm storm and smooths the seas once more.
Smooth and ruffled is the screen mantle, covering shoulders yearning to be bare.
These paired sets of arms entwine, we spread this mantle far and wide. Its comforting weight.
Shared. You want me to strike this model down, Demeter?
That won't be necessary. What I need is right here.
Sucker for poetry, what did I say?
Oh, well, now I would like to invite you all for a celebration. Please join us for the feast